But I got the three.
Okay.
And now the news.
If signs of inflation persist, the Federal Reserve's policymaking committee voted toward raising interest rates. But for now, they stated, they will hold interest rates steady. Back to you, Dot.
Better than my water. Anyway, you know, it's just been tragic. I moved, and what do I happen to lose? But the one thing that saves my life the most, my Walkman. And not to mention, it has that Madonna Ray of Light tape in it. I've just been lost. Back to you, Margo.
Thank you for that riveting report. A role model for people of color, a breast cancer survivor, and a remarkable person, they said. Linda Finley, an agent specialist for the Bureau of Criminal Apprehension, was congratulated by the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund, rewarding Finley for 26 years of service, 13 of them with the Bureau of Criminal Apprehension. Back to you, Dot.
You know, that tramp, Tom, he's been calling me a slut for years. Well, you wouldn't even believe what I found out. I had a friend of mine tell me over at the bar the other night that he had a four-way with his boyfriend. Talk about tacky. I just can't even believe it. And I'm the tramp.
Thank you for that riveting report.
You're welcome.
100 million Americans are considered overweight. But cheer up. Zinakel is the topic of the hubbub of the Hennepin County Medical Center. That's right. It appears safe and helps people shed those unwanted pounds. Zinakel binds itself to fat-digesting enzymes, blocking fat from being digested. And one-third of the undigested fat is flushed through the digestive system. There are a few side effects we should be aware of. Spotting of undergarments, gas and discharge, urgent needs to go to the bathroom, fatty and oily stools, increased bowel movements, and the inability to control them. Back to you, Dot.
Well, we noticed why you picked up that article. And after all, you have already all those symptoms, so it just won't make a difference.
My undergarments aren't spotty. Back to you, Dot.
Anyway, you know, I've just been thinking, they left that little water purifier in our house, and you know, I know it's supposed to only be good for 2 or 3 years. Well, I think it's about dead by now, because I don't know, the water just doesn't taste like it should, even though, like, St. Paul water doesn't taste that great in the first place. So I'm just beginning to wonder, don't you? Back to you, Margo.
Thanks, Dot. Did you know that estrogen links to co-activates? Wait a minute, links with you throw me off, girlfriend. Estrogen, did you know, estrogen linked to co-activators that stimulate the production of cancer cells. However, tamoxifen, say that with me, tamoxifen. It's one of the newest class of drugs used to fight breast cancer. That's right.
Woo-hoo!
Tamoxifen binds to the receptors in place of that estrogen. And this prevents the leaking with those coactivators and averts the growth of cancerous cells. One big wow for tamoxifen. Wow!
And remember, do those self-examinations.
I have a gentleman do it for me.
Yes, we know. Anyway, you know, I've been thinking. I have a friend of mine.
What?
What's wrong with you?
I'm
anyway,
worried.
You know, it's just so such a shame. James, you know, his boyfriend broke up with him the other day, and I just don't understand a bit of it. It's just tragic, if you ask me. I mean, here they are. The guy doesn't want, I guess we're in the wrong camera. The guy doesn't want a regular relationship, and yet when James wants to go out to a party that's like a sex club kind of thing, all of a sudden, James's boyfriend doesn't want to go through with it. It's just a shame, if you ask me. I mean, why is he going to break up with him over that?
Oh,
back to you, Margo.
Let me off the set.
Your wig's slipping.
I think that's just about enough news for one day, don't you? Remember, yesterday is history.
Tomorrow is a mystery.
And today is
a gift.
Weren't we fabulous?
I think we were just fabulous.
edition of Drag Queen 101. I'm your favorite drag queen, because, you see, I'm popular. Margo from Fargo. Yay!
Let's hear you!
Yay, me!
Let's talk about you.
Let's talk about me. This is a special edition because we're here today to talk about Project Off Streets. And we've got our Project Off Streets professionals here. And you are?
I'm Raquel with the GLBT Host Home Program.
Raquel with Host Home Program.
Yep.
GLBT Host Home. And you are?
I'm Paul. I'm a GLBT case manager at Project Off Streets.
That's exciting.
So we're the queer staff.
Yeah. The queer staff?
We're some of the queer
staff. We're some of the queer staff. There are more.
We're everywhere.
There are more of us there. Yeah.
This is really exciting, and I do think that to me, it's the most exciting because, as you were mentioning earlier, a big percentage of the population that are homeless happen to be GLBT. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
Yeah.
So I think this is just an excellent segue into trying to reach those people and be a resource for them. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the numbers are large. I mean, and they're large and they're growing. There are a lot of GLBT youth who are homeless. And that's actually one of the reasons that Off Streets has such a great GLBT, GLBT focused services, because there's a need out there. Paul does case management, and I work with volunteers who will open their homes to homeless queer youth. So, yeah, there's definitely a need.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
You know, if someone is interested in finding out more about Host Home Program, mm-hmm. what's the phone number, or how could they reach you? Or
they can reach me at 871-3613.
One more time?
871-3613, and just ask for Raquel.
Raquel.
And I can answer any questions that they have about the program.
That's exciting. Mm-hmm. And you're a case manager, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm doing a lot of the real direct service, working with mm-hmm. the kids, helping them get into school, helping them find places to live, get them back with their families, mm-hmm. tons of stuff.
Great job.
Yeah.
Yeah. And as a case manager, he refers youth to my program, and then I match that youth to a host volunteer, so that youth can move in into a host home.
Yeah, the Host Home Program is a great resource. I mean, it was like 2 years ago, a group of people got together and said, and really tried to identify a real gap in services, and it was, there's no housing for these kids. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, yeah, one of our jobs is to make referrals to housing, but where? Mm-hmm. So, came up with this great idea, and it's just been really very awesome to see.
Yeah. Yeah.
It come into reality.
Right.
So, isn't that exciting? And it's also brand new.
Yeah, it's brand new. It's just now up and running. I've spent the past, 7-8 months setting it up. And I did one application process with adults, so I have 6 homes now. And tonight, I actually start a new application process for more adults. So it's pretty exciting. And it's for youth 18 to 21. Oh,
okay.
So hopefully in the future, the Host Home Program will also be able to serve younger kids.
Younger population, but for right now, this is really exciting.
It's a good start.
Coordination and collaboration.
There you
and all
go.
Mm-hmm. Stuff. All those big
All the
words.
C words.
You know. Now, for kids to get in touch with you, I understand you have a 1-800 number?
Yeah.
What is that again?
It's 1-800-RUNENDS. So it's 1-800-RUN-ENDS. And, I mean, the reason we have it 800 number is because a lot of times these kids don't have any money.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have a place, so the way to go is to, they can just go to any payphone and give us a call. Mm-hmm.
That's exciting. And just for the viewers, where are you located again? What's that address?
It's 212 North 2nd Street. In the Warehouse District in Minneapolis, kind of near Moose and Sadie's, Nicky's.
Oh, okay.
A couple.
Mm-hmm. The restaurant?
Places. Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So kids can go there to get to get dinner, to get food, and to get case management and, referrals.
Yeah, it's also, I mean, it's just for some kids, it's a safe place off the streets. I mean, literally, just what the name says.
Yeah. I can't imagine being between a rock and a hard place. I happen to have terrific parents, but our home situation.
Mm-hmm.
If you're kicked out of your home and you have nothing, and you're going through such a tough period of time in your life, man, I can't imagine going through all of that.
Yeah,
you know, and then of course we bring up the issue of possible ways of making money, mm-hmm. which are not in your best interest, yeah. but they're easy.
Yeah, we,
and there's always right. people out there, you know, mm-hmm. who would like to give you money
yes.
for
yes.
for whatever. And the whole idea is to derail or get kids on the right track, I should say, mm-hmm. not derail them, mm-hmm. but get them off of that track. Get them on a track mm-hmm. where they can make more choices in their life, not just have the
right. Yeah, we work
one
with,
option of probably yeah. prostitution, or I yeah. don't know what else goes on, but I imagine that there's a whole lot that does not form an individual to be a productive member mm-hmm. of society.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah.
Off Street so
has
exciting.
A yeah. Off Street has a history of working with sexually exploited youth, youth involved in prostitution, because if you're homeless, obviously you're high risk of becoming involved, well, of engaging in survival sex and all of that stuff that you touched on. So, yeah. There's, and I also think that as a member of the queer community, we need to find a way to hold ourselves accountable, you know, for not taking care of queer youth or for exploiting queer youth, and do that in a way that doesn't reinforce the myth out there that, you know, right. all gay men are pedophiles. Cause,
stalking yeah, pedophiles
yeah,
and
right.
child molesters.
So we have to find a good balance.
This is just exciting. It really is. I don't know if I'm showing it. No, because it is. It's giving us a whole different fresh face and makes us our own, like you say, mm-hmm. responsible for our mm-hmm. own youth. Mm-hmm. And we can be more productive mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. members of society and perhaps, mm-hmm. hopefully, examples mm-hmm. to youth. Let's see. Whatever got you into social work? What? Paul.
Wow. No. I was a high school teacher for a while, and I knew I liked working with youth, and worked at District 202 for a while.
Oh, okay, I've heard of that. Never been there.
District 202 is a drop-in center for all queer youth mm-hmm. and their friends and allies.
Mm-hmm. Great place.
It is a very great place.
Great place.
And we work in collaboration. Mm-hmm. Another big word.
Collaboration.
With District 202 as often as possible. And I mean, my job is great. I get to spend time at District 202 just hanging out with the kids and, you know, connecting with them. And I get to spend time at another drop-in center over in St. Paul called Safe Zone, which is like Off Streets.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
But
in St. Paul?
Yeah, there's homeless kids in St. Paul as well. Because this is GLBT program at Project Off Streets is pretty unique. Mm-hmm. So if we can get out, you know, mm-hmm. and be talking with other agencies and getting the kids connected, mm-hmm. that's what we want to do. So mm-hmm. I got a great job. I love it.
Yeah,
excellent.
And he's great at it.
And
he
what
is.
The heck got you into this?
Oh, my God. How many hours is this program? I've always been interested in doing community organizing. That's sort of my take on social work. It's what I'm interested in. That's what I went to school for, to become a social worker. But my focus is very much in working with folks in different communities and doing coalition work. Collaboration, was that the word?
Collaboration. I'll say that together. Collaboration.
But can we spell it? That's the.
That's another
L.
Yeah. So I've always loved working with queer youth, and it's something that I think I'm good at. So, you know, it's nice to do something that you enjoy and that you do well. And I think that's probably something that Paul and I share.
And you know, it's so needed.
You know, if I were good at being a drag queen, that's what I would be. But I would be horrible at that, let me tell you.
Yeah.
It takes so much effort.
Well.
You have to shave. Well, you don't have to shave.
I would have to shave, and I don't know if I'm ready for that. So.
Tell me, what's the toughest part of your job, though? There must be some tough parts.
Actually, you know, because my program is fairly new, I'm still very much in the honeymoon phase.
Oh, okay.
I have a fabulous advisory council with folks from, you know, different organizations whom I work with, and they really help me out. So far, nothing has happened that has made me feel disillusioned. You know, the matches have been wonderful with, you know, youth and host homes. Everything is going well. You know, I think the hard part as, you know, in social work is just funding, basically. It's finding the money and making sure that your program has enough money to keep going. So
is the Minneapolis Youth Diversion Program working towards that funding, or how does that come about?
Well, all of our programs, I mean, Minneapolis Youth Diversion has several programs, but yeah, if folks want to donate money to Minneapolis Youth Diversion or to the GLBT services specifically,
they can call 1-800.
No, not that one. A different one.
For anyone that's interested
In helping out financially or volunteering. Well, financially,
sure.
They can call one. What's the number?
No.
871-3613. If folks want to
612.
Do a donation.
Yep.
871-3613 to donate.
Yeah, and if you want to donate clothes or, you know, like a household, you know, stuff for. What's the word I'm looking for?
Old toasters.
Like furnishings, items, household items.
Sounds like. You know, the off streets will take those donations as well, and that's the number for that is 338-3103.
338-3103 for all you cleaning out your closets, mm-hmm. or if you've got two toasters, two blenders, and don't know where to put it.
Yeah.
Because once kids get into places,
yep.
I mean, they don't have any stuff.
Yeah.
So.
Right. Pots, pans, silverware, whatever. Any of that.
Oh, yeah.
And the toughest part of your job?
Oh, boy. I think it's probably outside of worrying about the funding and all this kind of stuff, which is a whole different story. I think it's, you know, some kids, you know, it's not going to work. Mm-hmm. Whatever you do, you know, some kids are going to fall through the cracks and. You know, I mean, I think that was probably the hardest thing for me to come to terms with, mm-hmm. you know, and your sphere of influence is only so big, mm-hmm. so.
How are you able to sort of let that go and just open your doors for new kids?
Well, but, you know, there's plenty to do.
There's always. A mountain of work there.
Yeah.
I mean, into the next stack of work.
It would be amazing to come to work one day and not have anything to do. Have to close down shop, we're done, there are no more homeless kids, we figured it out, it's done.
Paul's job is really hard. I think being a case manager is incredibly hard, which is partly why, you know, I think for you to answer that question is harder than for me, because my job is more, I think, more manageable, also emotionally maybe, just as far as being on the, you know, front lines.
Because I think a lot of the times, a lot of these kids, you know, they're coming into our doors and they don't believe that there are people who care. Mm-hmm. You know, and
especially queer adults.
Exactly.
Also.
Right.
Yeah.
And
right.
I mean, so they're looking at us and they're thinking, "You're going to exploit me."
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
what. And then, and mm-hmm. so sometimes it's a long, gradual process of saying, "No, we're not. We're here to do the right things." So.
Mm-hmm. That's exciting. Now, was there? Did we cover this or not? Was there room for volunteers?
You go. You go,
okay, I'll go. Well, actually, there's room for volunteers. I think for Paul's program, there's definitely room for volunteers. And the number to call if you're interested is 338-3103. Again, that's the number for off streets. And to talk to the volunteer coordinator, and her name is Ping Lu.
Ping Lu? Yes.
Ping
Lu? 338-3103.
Yes.
Ping Lu?
Yeah. And
we'll take care of you.
And then for folks who are interested in being a host volunteer and being part of the host home program, then they can contact me at 871-3613.
That's exciting. Well, thanks for joining us.
Great. Thank you. This was great.
And if there's any kids out there that do need help, because my brain is fried, 1-800.
Run ends.
1-800 run ends. I think that's the most important.
That's right. You know, but with these lights, I'm not surprised that your brain is fried.
That's true.
Sure is hot over here.
Ready to blow a big drag queen kiss to our table viewing audience?
Oh, yes.
Oh, wow.
1, 2, 3. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Wait.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
And that word, collaboration, just fabulous.
Fabulous.
Thanks for joining us.
Welcome to another edition of Doing It With Dot. This week, we're going to have callers for lovelorn advice. You know, I always love giving advice about love, and now I'll actually get to have a one-on-one with my viewing audience. So, caller one, I think I can hear you.
Hi, Dottie, how are you?
Hi, it's nice to meet you. What's your name?
Jennifer.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Jennifer. So, what do you need?
Well, I've been dating this guy for about 2 weeks, and you know, Valentine's Day is coming up, and I was just wondering, what's an appropriate first day gift?
Well, most of my boyfriends have liked a strap-on, but you might want something a little different. Now, wouldn't that be correct?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you know, men don't like candy all the time, especially like a lot of the men I know, because, you know, they're getting kind of large. Once they get in a relationship, they lose it, and they just start gaining weight left and right. Not unlike men and women that get married, but that's another story. Anyway, you know, I've always thought a great thing for men would be tools. I know it sounds strange, but you can get them a power tool. It's kind of a sexual thing for them, believe it or not. So try out a power tool, especially a drill. Makes them feel all macho.
Thanks.
Okay, next caller. Caller number two.
Hey, Dottie.
Hey, how's it going? What's your name?
Fred.
Hey, Fred. What you got?
I was wondering the difference between love and infatuation.
Well, love is when your dick doesn't get hard, and infatuation is when it gets so hard you can't get it to go away. No. Anyway, actually, love lasts, infatuation doesn't. You know, a lot of people get really confused when they first meet someone. You know, you have to wait. That's why it's really good before you get engaged to wait a really long time, because, you know, I'd say 6 months, you know, anywhere between 2 days and 6 months. But anyway, because, you know, infatuation can last at least a month. So you might want to wait before you have a move in on the first date. You know what I mean? I had a girlfriend that did that. She ended up being like left with a $4,000 phone bill. Terrible, isn't it? Okay, you need anything else? Well, I guess we've lost him. Not surprising. He sounded like a geek, didn't he? Anyway, I think we've got another caller on the line.
Hey, Dottie?
Yes?
Could you tell me how you know your mate's cheating or not?
Well, that's easy. Does he have racing stripe on his knees?
I haven't checked lately.
Well, you might. There's also another few good ways. You know, a lot of people say it's not good to be a snoop. What do they know? Anyway, always go to the laundry. Little telltale signs. I know you've always heard about the lipstick on the collar, but there are other ways too. Let's see, what are the ways that I figured out? You know, you can always taste it on their breath. Believe it or not, try kissing them a good long kiss. Not that we always do that with our long-term relationships, but give them a good long kiss, and believe it or not, you can taste it on their breath. You know what I'm talking about. So, thank you for joining us for this edition of Doing It With God, and all of our callers, thank you so much for helping us out. And remember, there's nothing like doing it with God. You take care, okay? Bye-bye now.
Charles, oh, we need you.
Orisha testing is a mouth swab that takes a sample of cells from the inside lining of your mouth and tests for HIV antibodies, just like a blood test. Mm. Only there's no blood draw necessary. It's a really painless test, and we offer it free of charge to people who think they may be at risk for HIV.
How long do you think that test takes to get the results back?
That's a really good question. We can turn the results around in 1 week or less.
Mm. Well, that's a big help for a lot of people, I'm sure. Okay, on to the next thing. Hi.
Hello.
Well, this is the AIDS line area.
Hi.
This is the AIDS line area. This is where we take all of the calls to the AIDS line in the state of Minnesota.
Oh, so it's like an AIDS helpline?
It's an AIDS helpline.
Do you know that number offhand in case any of them want to meet you? Warm up your hands.
No.
Isn't the kind of man cute?
That's a man?
No.
Yeah, they come in all shapes and sizes, you know.
I've heard but never seen.
What's that number?
It's locally 373-2437.
373-2437.
Yay!
Spells AIDS.
Oh.
Or 1-800-248-AIDS.
Well, that's just terrific. Is that 24 hours a day or certain times?
No,
or okay.
Monday through Friday. It's Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m.
Okay.
And Friday's 9 to 6.
So that really covers it anyway.
The epidemic doesn't stop, but we do.
But we do.
So what happens here? What, you know.
Well, people call and they tell us their sexual fantasies, and we... No, I'm kidding.
So that's what you do all day.
I'm working off a sweat. Anyway,
oh my.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Ow.
Continue.
I just want you all to know that you all are having the opportunity to see something very different than we normally see in professional settings.
Thank
like
you.
Like Scott grabbing himself. Anyway, no.
Oh, I'm sure they see it all the time.
Hey, also, if someone wanted to become a volunteer, is there like a screening process or are there things that people could do to help out? Or
any old bum walk out the street?
Actually, we don't use volunteers. We'd rather pay a high-paid staff
okay.
to do all of our work. I'm kidding.
Trained professionals.
This is a volunteer-based organization.
How highly are you paid?
Of course, not enough.
And your company car?
Lavish expense accounts. Mm. No, it is a vault. What is poking me in the elbow? It's called a tickle.
Not one. Not
two.
Just warn me when we get to hut three.
It's scary, I'll tell you.
Should we start over with a welcome?
No!
No, anyway, it is a volunteer-based organization, and people can call the AIDS line to get information about volunteer opportunities here or in other organizations in the Twin Cities and greater Minnesota. So we give people lots of information about volunteering, and they can help them connect with whatever they want to.
Wonderful. So what kind of problems do you handle on a general basis?
We handle everything from people who are concerned about their risk for HIV and want some more information about that to what's happening. What? Margo from Fargo disappeared behind me. We handle everything from people who are concerned about their risk to people who have just found out that they actually have HIV to people who are living with HIV or AIDS and need help connecting with services in the community. And we do all of that from here.
Well, that's fabulous.
What a terrific resource.
Mm. Well, thanks for
hanging on.
Thank you
so.
All right. Are we still in the picture? Are you filming our crotch?
No.
No, but I have a feeling we don't see a lot of me. Of course, as usual, we'll get all of you and nothing of me.
Hmm?
Not that we care that much.
No.
We're not big
fans.
Oh,
your address. That's a good one, too.
What, so what is the address?
And I hear you've got a website.
We do. Our address on the web is www.mnaidsproject.com. No, .org. I'm sorry, .org.
Okay.
And our address...
he's supposed to be the boss.
They just pay me to act like one. And our address is 1400 Park Avenue South, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55404. Our email address for the AIDS line, if you want to correspond with me or anyone else here, is mapal@bitstream.net.
Bitstream?
Yes.
And he's really not reading it.
Okay, who can really keep track of all of this information? Can we sit down for this
one? Can we sit down?
Okay, let's sit
down. My app's open.
And currently you've got the helpline running.
Right.
What other things are you?
We basically do three things at the Minnesota AIDS Project. We do education and prevention services for people who are at risk for HIV, and we do that through a number of different ways. We do some specific work in the gay and bisexual community. We do some syringe exchange and interventions for injecting drug users. And then the AIDS line is one source of information for people. We also do direct services for people through case management, transitional housing, providing volunteer buddies, legal assistance, etc. And also helping people through the AIDS line get connected with the resources they need. And then we do public policy advocacy, community organizing, advocacy at the legislative level to try and influence laws.
You got your hands full. Well, this has just been fun. Is there anything else you'd like to bring up?
Well, I would like to tell you about two other things that we do through the AIDS line. One is called Positive Link, which is anonymous conversations between people who are positive or force. I really just want to start that over. That was just a really crappy explanation.
Okay, you're lying.
This is just terrific. Is there anything else you'd like to bring up?
I would like to tell you about two other things that people can do through the AIDS line. One is to, if there's somebody living with HIV, they can talk with somebody else who's living with HIV by phone to get support, to talk about medication issues, to talk about whatever may be going on with them. They simply call the AIDS line and we can connect them with somebody who works at the Positive Link.
That's wonderful.
The other thing that a lot of people don't know that we do in this program is we meet with people face to face. And we can do that anonymously or confidentially, not just for testing, but to actually help someone. Well, why didn't you say so sooner?
Just nervous!
But we can also meet with someone face-to-face to help them connect with services. We help people fill out applications for public benefits, emergency financial assistance, get connected to case management programs. And we do that by phone, but some people prefer to do it face-to-face, and so they can meet with one of our staff face-to-face also.
That's wonderful.
I know I've wanted an outlet like that. different reasons, but...
Oh, well, thanks so much for having us come.
Like I said, it was the most fun part of my
time. This is just fabulous. And everyone here was so sweet and nice. We are so glad. I can just honestly thank you for everyone around that uses this service, that you are here, because you are so much such a big help to everyone, and you are such a big service, and I know, like, there's just not enough that we could even say to thank you.
Well, thank you. And if you want to help out, you're or be a volunteer, feel free to dial their number. Their number was...
373-AIDS.
AIDS.
Or 1-800-248-AIDS.
248-AIDS. Mm-hmm. Well, thanks again.
Thank you.
Want to blow a drag queen kiss to our cable audience?
Okay.
1, 2, 3. Wow. Goodbye, everybody. Bye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
You're pretty cute.
Well, this has just been fun. Thanks a lot for inviting us again.
I'm so glad you came.
All right. You have a door.
And it's a lovely door.
Thanks for showing us.
Goodbye. Aren't they fun? Good luck. Now
they'll just go.
You know,
when we finally have our moment alone, Donnie is locked out and.
Yeah. Well, this is fun.
To another edition of Drag Queen 101 with your drag queen professionals, Donnie and Margo! Yay! thank you so much. After all, we are fabulous. Who's fabulous?
We are!
And you are too. In fact, this episode is specifically designed to make you fabulous too. That's right. It deals with the bigger issue that drag queens deal with. Lip sync! Yay! A drag queen without lip sync is like a day without toilet paper.
And remember, it takes a lot of skill.
That's right. And when you don't have the skill, hey, we've got some pointers to keep you out there in public and not carted away by the police.
Or just kicked off the stage by Dee. Of course, that's an old joke. Dee hasn't been around for a long time.
We love you, Dee.
Well,
we love
you.
Dee? We're actually big fans of yours.
Do 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 do.
We love you, Dee.
We are now controlling the television.
And your minds.
Oh, look, we have adoring fans.
Hi,
fans.
Hi.
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 You can't see them.
They want to know all about lip sync. Well, here's what I do. Now, every once in a while, and I'm just rushing off to the bar, or they play my tape, and I can't remember which song is exactly coming up, I've got a few pointers that'll make me look terrific without even knowing the lyrics. Yay!
That's a what?
Lip syncing.
Lip syncing? Why, yes. One of the little trade secrets that I've learned is to use a lot of head movements. That way, if the lyrics begin or end without you actually catching up with them, no one will notice. They'll be just looking at your terrific, terrific hair.
Not to mention...
Try it in your chairs now. Isn't that wonderful? I just love that part.
Not to mention, if you're showing the back of your head, if you're Margo, it looks a lot better.
Hey, I've got another great idea. If you're a little tense and a little nervous, all you do is hold a microphone in front of your lips, and no one really knows if you're singing along with it or not. Let's try that together. Everybody grab something like a microphone and hold it up to your lips. How professional is that? Isn't that just great? That's right. Another big mistake people use when they are lip syncing is to open their lips a little bit too wide. Do not do that. Do not try to keep your lips pretty, pretty. If you notice real singers, they, except for opera singers, you lip sync like an opera singer, actually. Yes. I'm almost nearly certain that that's how you're lip syncing. But most people, if you leave your lips a little bit smaller, then it's easier to cover if you lip sync when you're off a beat, actually, or it's more believable that you're singing the true lyrics. It's just wonderful. And the last thing is, do not sing along, if you do know the lyrics, don't sing along with the record, because that's very annoying in the audience. Okay, are you ready to try some real lip sync here, everyone?
You know, I've actually, just to go back to that topic,
oh, sure.
I've actually been to shows where you've heard It sounds really tacky where they're trying not to sing it, but they are anyway.
It's oh, no. It's really annoying to those that are trying.
It's just tacky.
So they're trying to believe you're that entertainer, and you're just not helping them out at all.
Okay, so shall we try?
Okay, let's try. Okay, everybody, stand up. That's right.
Stand up again.
Okay. Maestro, if you please. Now we're trying... first of all, try saying banana together. Banana, banana, banana.
Banana, 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 banana.
And the part B for the intermediate is watermelon. Try that together now. Watermelon, 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 watermelon. Now the advanced drag queen lip sync along is when you combine the two, banana, then watermelon. Ready? Banana, watermelon, banana, watermelon.
Banana, watermelon.
Lots of head movements. Keep your lips small. And let's go, maestro. If
banana,
you please.
Banana, 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 watermelon. Banana,
watermelon. Banana, watermelon. Woo!
It worked.
Oh, here comes some music now. Remember, try not to sing along with the words. It gets very annoying. This is a head movement. Banana, banana.
Everybody, this is a drag queen. This is a drag queen on drugs. Get the picture?
Dottie will say, sure. And then you say, welcome to the Astor Cafe. Hey.
Also natural language.
Okay. Hey, do you have a cigarette?
Oh, sure, honey. Well, hi. You're good looking. What's your name?
My name's Ann.
Hi, Ann.
This is the Astor Cafe.
Why, thanks. This looks like a terrific... Get over there and bring my camera shot.
I'm trying to save the viewers.
So what do you like best about the Astor?
It's got the best meals, you can always count every day. There's the chicken pot pie.
Chicken pot pie. Oh, you've got to try that someday. Did you hear that? Chicken pot pie is the best ones in the Twin Cities, right here at the Astor Cafe.
You can be inside, see the water, play some bread.
Oh, the windows are terrific.
Perfect.
Oh, it's so exciting.
And it's about a 2-second walk from my work. Perfect.
What could be better?
That's close.
And you can smoke, huh, Dottie?
Oh, fabulous. We have a whole smoking section.
Just for Anna Dottie.
You know, the government just pressing down way too hard on that. It's just limiting our freedom.